بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين، أما بعد. اللهم لا سهل إلا ما جعلته سهلا، وأن تجعل الحزن إذا شئت سهلا. In this meeting we are highlighting here about the paradise Jannah and the reasons of entering a Jannah, the science of entering a Jannah. First of all, the Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam explained about the Jannah. What is Jannah? What is paradise? In his hadith whereby he says, فيها ما لا عين رأت. It is there in Jannah, a things that no one seen it. ولا أذن سمعت, and no one heard it. ولا خطر على قلب بشر, and nothing came in a feeling a person, a human being. It is something beyond our thinking, beyond our knowledge, beyond our understanding. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prepared that Jannah for a people who are suitable for that place to be in. Here we will mention the reasons of entering the Jannah. That is a drive from the Quran and Sunnah. Number one, first reason to enter Jannah is at-tawheed, the pure tawheed. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, من كان آخر كلامه لا إله إلا الله دخل الجنة. When a person passes away, if last words from him is لا إله إلا الله, there is no God through God to worship except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that person will enter Jannah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is number one. If you go to pure tawheed, you are aqeedah, your tawheed is clean from shirk, is pure, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward you to enter a Jannah. Number two of reasons to enter a Jannah is iqamu salah, to establish the salah. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, خمس صلوات كتبهن الله على العباد. Allah سبحانه وتعالى prescribed 5 times prayers in a day and night. فمن جاء بهن لم يضيع منهن شيئا استخفافا بحقهن كان له عند الله عهد أن يدخله الجنة. Whosoever performs these 5 salats without wasting, it is times without wasting the meaning of these prayers, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promised him to put in Jannah. Then the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam also says, من صلى البردين دخل الجنة. Whoever performs Salah, the 2 times that was mentioned by Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, which is Salatul Asr and Salatul Subh, will enter Jannah with the grace of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Another hadith Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, من صلى 12 ركعة في يوم وليلة بني له بهن بيت في الجنة. Whosoever performs 12 rak'ah, 12 rak'ahs in a day and night, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will build a house for him in Jannah. That is number two. Number three of the reasons of entering Jannah is as-siyam, fasting. So if you fast Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make a way for you to Jannah. من ختم له بالصيام يوم دخل الجنة. So whoever died, passes away while he is fasting, and his last action was fasting, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put him in Jannah. Number four, تقوى الله تبارك وتعالى. تقوى الله, to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Fearing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is a reason to enter a Jannah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, إن المتقين في جنات ونهر. Those people are fearing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they have been in the Jannah and the rivers of Jannah, في مقعد صدقاً عند ملك مقتدر, by the respect of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, by the grace of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they will remain a host in the presence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the day of Yawm al-Qiyamah. So it's very important to observe and to maintain the taqwa of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at all times, to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala all positions, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala He's a judge. He's a judge there. Allah is the one subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you to enter a Jannah because you fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Number five of the reasons to enter a Jannah is a birrul walidain, to be kind to the parents. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, دخلت الجنة فسمعت بها قراءة فيها قراءة فقلت من هذا؟ قالوا حارثة بن نعمان. The Rasulullah said, the night of Isra and Mi'raj, he says, I entered a Jannah and I heard someone reading, reciting Quran, and I asked, who is that? They told me, حارثة بن نعمان. فقال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, هكذا البر, هكذا البر. That is how the bir and the kindness to the parents treats the person in the day of Yawm al-Qiyamah. And Haritha ibn Nu'man was the best person for his mother in his time. So Allah subhanahu reward him in Jannah al-Firdaus to recite the Quran there. Number six of the reasons to be in Jannah is husn tarbiyat al-banat, to prepare the children, especially the females. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, man kana lahu thalatha banat. Whoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have given him three girls of his children. يؤدبهن ويكفيهن ويرحمهن. He prepares them, he teaches them, he covers them with his mercy, and he feel for them. فقد وجبت له الجنة. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make him a Jannah for him. He will enter a Jannah by the grace of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala because of that good action, because of that kindness for the three girls. One is same, three and more than that, all is going to the same way, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving you Jannah because of your girls, that you prepare them for the good future in their deen especially. The seventh one, ihsanu zawja li zawja, when the wife is very kind to her husband, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prepare a Jannah for her. For Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was asked by a lady about the kindness of the husband, and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, فَانْدُرِي أَيْنَ أَنْتِ مِنْهُ فَإِنَّهُ جَنَّتُكِ أَوْ نَارِكِ. He asked and tell her, he directed the lady and tell her, check where are you from your husband. What is your position with your husband? If he loves you, if you are kind to him, because he is your Jannah and he is your Nar. That means he is the one who is causing for your Jannah and can cause you for a Nar. We stop here and we continue inshallah ta'ala to the next lecture. And we stop here inshallah ta'ala. Wa sallallahu wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.